So I decided to be a Christian. How did a girl who was non-religious all of a sudden decided to believe in Jesus? So in this video, I want to really share with you my journey of how I found God and how He's really changed my life. Hey guys, it's Linh Podetti here and welcome to my channel. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button for notification for when my videos are up. Now, in this channel, my dedication is to share how you can achieve time and financial freedom. And once upon a time, I was a single mom, broke, and just desperate to change my life. And now my life has changed. And here's an example. God, my hair is just all over. Here's an example of where it's changed. Like right now, I'm on a little getaway holiday with my husband in the country town, in Blue Mountains. And, you know, this was my dream back in the days when I was, you know, just didn't have anything. I just dreamed of being able to just travel anywhere, anytime, whenever I feel like it. And I can now. And so, you know, that dream can be yours as well if you just, I guess, follow the right steps, have that dream and dare to dream. But anyway, in this video, I really want to share with you how God has really changed my life and why this year I decided to be a Christian, because I would say that the last 10 years, I have gone deeper and deeper into spirituality. And it's led me to where I am. And I would say that it is the reason why I have achieved the success that I have. So that is why I want to share with you how I've got to this point with my spirituality or how I found God. Okay, so about 10 years ago, when my life really hit rock bottom, I remember kneeling down and just going, God, help me. Like, why is it that I keep attracting all these bad luck in relationships and things just always go wrong? And I remember almost just like begging for someone higher to kind of help me. And I guess I throw the word God around, not really understanding it. It's kind of like the saying, oh my God and God, whatever. But I didn't really have that connection or I didn't really know who this person or this God is. But I definitely remember the moment begging to God, going, please, like, you know, what do I do from here? And from that moment on, I started to I started to find signs of things. So like, for example, I found a life coaching course, which got me into learning about personal development. And then I learned everything about reality and beliefs and everything. And then I also came across Oprah, and then I came across Esther Hicks, who really talk about the law of attraction. And so within that year that I started to learn more about personal development and law of attraction, I started to just, you know, follow the rules of putting out my dreams, believing in it and manifesting it. And then a year later, all the things that I wanted in that year, I achieved it. Like finding a husband, you know, living in a nicer house, having a new car. So all of that just manifested in within that year. And so I finally kind of realized that there is something out there. It's like, how does this kind of miracle work where you basically dream something, put something dream out there and just believing in it and then just really trust that it's going to happen and just really, you know, try your best and be that example. But overall, it's just this kind of faith. And that's when I realized that there is something higher out there. It's not just us human beings living on this earth, but there is really this higher self out there that is watching everything that you're doing. And if you trust in this universe or this spirit or this something, that you will start to manifest things. And because I had the miracles happening for me in that year, that was when I kind of realized that life is a miracle. All life, there is something that is beyond ourselves. Like, we can't control everything, that there is something else looking out for us. And so I would say the last 10 years, I got deeper and deeper into spirituality, and I really do rely on my faith, kind of like whatever things that I decide on, if ever I want to take a leap in a decision in business or in anything, I always know that it's going to work out because it kind of already worked out, you know, in that 10 years ago, it worked out. The first time it worked out, and it was such a miracle that I know that more miracles will come. And so I would say that being spiritual has been a 10-year journey. But then last year, there was a calling. I felt like I needed to read the Bible. There was this voice in my head that says, read the Bible, like, or that you that the teachings that you're learning about law of attraction and everything that you're learning around is probably the same principles that are taught in the Bible, but it's just so different that you don't understand it. And read the Bible. Oh no, there was like, it's like a voice in my head. And anyway, January this year, I decided that I wanted to check out, before I went to Hillsong, the church, what happened was I found a video on YouTube. It was a guy named Pastor Vlad, and he was like a pastor in America, and he started to, I remember the video was called Things Get Worse Before They Get Better. I was just trying to dig up something and I found that video. And then when I came across him, I just fell in love with the message, with the things he's talking about God, but then the lessons are very applicable to life. And I couldn't stop watching it. And I really go, oh my God, I really resonate with the teachings of Christianity and Jesus and everything that's about law of attraction is so similar to trust in God, trust in Jesus, trust that everything will work out. It's just that the law of attraction or that seems more easier to put your head around if you're not religious, if you know me. Because if you're religious, if you're not religious and you hear religion, you're kind of like, ugh, weird. And so I feel like law of attraction and the things I learned before was kind of like the beginning step of Christianity or something. So anyway, I then got myself to go to church and I went to Hillsong. And I know it's a global company. I mean, it's based in Australia, but there's branches all around the world. And I went there and I just started crying. It was as if I found home. You know, their slogan is called Welcome Home. I went to this church and tears were just running down my face. I couldn't explain. Like, I'm listening to the songs they're singing. I'm listening to the message that they're preaching. And I am surrounded by very spiritual people, people that I believe in God, in a higher self, in that life isn't all about you controlling it. You know, you have to surrender. You have to trust that you do need help sometimes, that you don't have to come up with all the answers. And so, there's this overwhelming feeling that I got. It's like I found something that I didn't know I was missing. And so that was January. And I have really enjoyed the journey of becoming a Christian. And when I say becoming a Christian, it's not like I've been baptized or anything, but I just studied more about Christianity. And everyone who I meet have had similar experiences where one day they just they might have been brought up as a Christian, but they kind of steer away from the religion due to whatever reason, but then they found God again. Or there's people like me who kind of just found it and to be honest, finding Christianity and finding God, it was such a good timing, because I just had this sense of confidence and I knew that that I can trust in God, and everything that I was learning about Christianity really helped me to prepare for the coronavirus. So when the coronavirus hit, I was much more prepared. I felt like, that's okay. You know, God will look after us and God will be there and you just have to trust. And I would say that it has given me so much strength. So what is my message for this video? My message for this video is that even if you don't have a religion, even if you have a particular religion and it's not Christianity, and if you have steered away from any of your faith, do try to bring it back on, because I believe that life isn't this kind of logical, like what you see is what you get. The people and the circumstances that are happening are just like whatever's happening. It really is beyond our control. Like, or what I mean is everything happens for a reason, and God or the universe or whatever your religion is has a better plan for you. And, you know, as a reminder, I was a single mom. I was broke. And in that year, there was no way that I could all of a sudden change my life in that year. But because I was willing to surrender to kind of like, God, help me, what do I do? In a way, it's like praying to God and going, look, I don't know all the answers. I don't have the control. I don't know what's going to happen next, but please help me. And that's when my life kind of changed. And, you know, now what I do is that I'm going back to, now that I've becoming more of a Christian, it's reminded me to go back to that mindset of surrendering, of praying, of knowing that you don't know everything and you don't have to. Just ask, just pray, just know what you want, but trust. Don't worry, because if you trust that everything will work out, then you shouldn't be worrying. And when you trust is when you would have more faith in pursuing whatever step that you want to do. Let's say you want to start something, do something. If you trust it will work out, then you'll do it. But if you don't trust and you're worried too much, you'll never take the lesson. So the whole point is that even if you are a Christian or religious or believe in a God, when there is a voice, when there is something telling you to do something or get out of that bad relationship or to do something, you still have to do it. You know, it's not like I'm just going to sit there and do nothing and God will take care of me. No, it's God will give you the guidance, the answers, the ideas, but you got to pursue it. And then pursuing, knowing that you either learn from the lesson because he needs you to learn and build your character, or you're going to succeed because God has the perfect plan for you. And so that is my journey to Christianity. I'm really curious if you're watching this and you have found God in any way. Love to hear your story in the comments below. But if you have any questions around this, let me know. But you know, I would say that I was someone that was not religious. I wasn't brought up with kind of any religion. My parents are more like Buddhism. I went to Catholic school, but I kind of didn't believe. I'm like, oh, it's just a fun story or something, or a legend, or kind of like a made-up story. And so I found God and spirituality in my own term. And I think everyone has their own journey, and everyone needs to find their own journey. There's no way that you can just go, oh, I'm gonna be spiritual tomorrow. It's like you gotta have a desire to think deeper, like you know, what is my purpose in life, you know, who am I? And then and then when you hear these voices, or when you get signs from the universe, that God, really go and pursue that, and then your journey to spirituality will get deeper, and it will give you this strength, this this faith that everything will work out, confidence, and you don't feel you're alone. And the best thing is you're surrounded by other spiritual people who just look at life the same way as you. They look at life in a more positive, a more supportive kind of way. So anyway, hope you enjoy my video about my journey in becoming a Christian. And if you enjoy this video and you're new and you haven't subscribed, please don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you again next time.